Hello noobs, so today I'm going to be showing you a bunch of tips on how to become a pro at trading. Alright, so these tips are not for like noobs, these are not like how to get started in trading. These are actual like good tips that could even help players with 100k plus value. These will probably assist anyone under a million, unless you're like really a pro trader, because these are very high quality good tips. And yeah, so the first tip is knowing how to projected flip. So anybody could projected flip, but you have to know what projections to get at first. So the best projections to get are not like eggs or anything with high demand. You want low demand, bigger projections. And to get them, I would say get them at about 2k depending on where it is. So 6k wrap, you try to get it around 2k. 8k wrap, like 3.5k. You want to try to get it for like a third of what it's going for wrap wise. And trade it off, you want to try to get it for about half. So if it's 8k 4k, 6k 3k, you want to try to make at least 1 to 3k profit, and if you're lucky you might make more. Tip number two, look for unassuming like noobs and trade hangout. I've done this before and it has worked. It's very easy to flip projecteds with them, and sometimes they just come up to you and ask you for trades, so it's really good. Always try to look for someone that looks like they don't know what they're doing, someone that might not be spelling words correctly, bad grammar, bad avatar, etc. The third tip is knowing how projecteds work. So projections work by hordes and a lot of people buying them in one day. So big items will not get projected most of the time. So if you want to project an item, you could either hoard it or whatever, but you have to know how projecteds work before you actually get into projecteds. Tip number four, memorize the values of items. I know this is kind of like a baby tip, but still, even some top traders don't always memorize it, so try to memorize the values on your own and know what it gets. Try to get into community, servers, anything. And that leads us to tip number five, being try to make friends with people that are richer than you and try to watch YouTubers such as myself. So you have to try to figure out as many things about trading. So try to make friends with some of the richer Robloxians, just so you could learn how to make better trades. They could help you. Maybe you add them on Discord and they could help you with your trading. Just don't be too annoying, because they're not very nice, to be fair. So they're not very nice, to be honest. But if you want help with trading, you got to make friends with them if you're somewhat new. Step number six, demand. So with demand, you need to understand demand. You cannot get demand when it's high. So if super happy face is at 120k, it's pointless for you trading for it with like an 8k OP, because there's no way it's gonna go up. The demand is terrific, it's not gonna like completely crash, but the demand is too good and it's just a face, it cannot go past where it is. So when you're getting demand, try to get it low, because it won't really fluctuate too much. So when you get it low, the worst that's gonna happen, maybe it goes down 10k, but don't flip it right away, because it will eventually go back up. You just have to wait. Step number seven, rares. So all the big items above a million, they're all rares, but I doubt anyone watching this video is in need of trading tips when you're above a million value, or have items above a million value. So with rares, you want to try to not OP too much if you can, because rares are very weird. They will fluctuate a ton. They could be a 130k one day and then go down to 60k. That's what happened, like all the old swords like Lumina and stuff like that, they just went down like crazy. Or your rares should go up a lot. But in order for your rares to go up, you have to do your part. You have to proof the items, you have to get books, you have to get with other people, you have to proof the items in order for you to make any profit with them. Because if you're not proofing, that means other people might not be proofing, and it's no proofs, rares will just go right down, because rares are based off of proofs, and obviously it's rarity. Step number eight, use Rolemons. Alright, so I know all you guys know how to use Rolemons, but I'm gonna teach you some ways how to use Rolemons. So always go to the deals page, and if you wanted to snag a good deal, try to get any deal above 25% on smaller items, and on bigger items, if you can get 15 to 20%, that would be good. But try not to resell them, trade them, don't resell them, because most of the time you won't get an item so low that you could buy it and then resell it for and make the same amount of Robux back, or make a profit off of it. You would probably have to trade it. That would be the better plan if you want to make deals with it. But with smaller items, if you get deals like 25%, you want to try to sell them. I've made like 10,000 Robux profit over like the last month just by doing that. You don't even have to like stay in the deals page for like an hour. Just check it every now and then for like a minute, like a minute every hour whenever you can. And if you could snag a good deal every now and then, make some Robux, it's always helpful. All right, guys. Tip number 10, make friend groups. So the reason why, because if you need like someone to give you like 40k, or if you need to give someone 40k, they always got you. Richer friend groups, if you are richer, they always help you. And if you're watching a tip video, most probably you need some help with trading. So always try to make friends, get people that could support you, help you, whatever. Make Discord servers, use, and also with bigger trades, try to use middleman, everything. All right, guys, so that is it. These were not technically pro trade tips, but they were not for like beginner noobs. Anyone that is like 40k value probably would need these. So yeah, that's it. Follow my Twitter. Bye, noobs.